this video, I'm gonna show you how to do a fro-hawk. Kind of like a Mahomes cut, and then line up his beard. Hope you guys enjoy. God bless. Take care. See you next one.
Alright guys, let's get this tutorial started. This is my friend Ray Ray, also known as Rironi, Denzel Washington. And we're going to start off with combing out his hair. You guys will pick it out, but I like using a comb just because we're really going to get the size. And as always, I'm always going to start off with my Andes T eyeliner cordless and set myself a bald guideline. And with this kind of fade, it's kind of difficult. It's almost like a taper burst faux hawk fade. But if you just follow the guideline I made, that's basically all you're going to need to just follow guideline after guideline. Now switched over to my Babbler's Gold FXs with the lever open. We're going to set ourselves about a quarter inch to a half inch guideline above the first initial guideline we made. And with this, you really want to flick out, especially with his kind of hair. It will just make everything a lot easier. Now slapping on my 1.5 guard and starting with the lever open, setting ourselves about an inch guideline above the last initial guideline we made. And you want to slowly, gradually push down to the closed lever. And it's pretty nice to have the gold FXs because they have like notches when you close the lever, so you really keep track of where you're at when you're closing the lever. And I honestly do recommend this clipper if anybody really wants to start out. It's pretty pricey, but honestly it's worth it. After our 1.5 guard, we're going to slap on our 1 guard, and of course we're going to start with the lever open, and we're going to start to slowly fade it in. Same routine, just slowly, gradually closing your lever to the closed position. Just try not to go above the 1.5 guard guideline that we made earlier. Now back to our lever open, we're going to follow that same guideline we made first with the lever open and start to gradually close down our lever, and this should fade out that very first guideline we made with the Andes T eyeliner. Now over to our zero guard, this is the last guard we're going to use, and with this one you just want to look at the guideline that we have left and just start with the lever open and slowly gradually closing the lever down again, and this should really just finish out the whole fade. Now I'm doing clip over comb, and I know people find it weird that I use clip over comb on ethnic hair because of course it's almost like comb gets stuck when they're in the hair, but I always find this flawlessly. Some people like using guards, some people just like freehanding it, but I like using the clip over comb just because it's a lot easier on my hand, and honestly I think it's way quicker. And same thing with it, just be sure you have it between a 45 and 90 degree angle off the head, and only trim off the hairs that you see that are sticking out. Now it's the exact same steps on the other side, so I'm gonna speed this side up and I'm gonna shut up. Now I switched over to my rose gold FX's trimmers, and I'm gonna take off his sideburns and his cheek hairs. He only wants to keep the goatee. So, but after I get this done, I'm gonna go with start line up around the C cup area. And with the C cup area, I just follow its natural hairline, and you're gonna see that his hairline's not really even. One side's gonna be a lot larger than the other. It's just the way his hairline is. He doesn't really like getting pushed back. So, just basically with hairlines, you know, you don't really want to push any of the hair back. So, just try to avoid that as much as possible. And with this part, you especially don't want to push back the hairline. I just really just follow his natural hairline. You can see where he has some spots where it's kind of patchy, and I don't really like using fibers on any haircut unless it's a photo, but with this I just follow his natural hairline. And instead of going to a pointed faux hawk in the back like what most people get, he likes getting it rounded off. And I believe that this actually makes his haircut look a lot better going around it off, because sometimes the point is too exaggerated, and with this way it's more natural looking. Now with my straight razor, pulling the skin, I'm just following the lineup where we made with our trimmers. And with this part, you really do want to stretch the skin, because if you don't, you're prone to nick him or anything. And with that, that's pretty much a bad day for both of us. Here's the finished look, you guys. I sponged it, made it look nice and neat. Hope you guys like it. Hope you guys got something out of it. And I hope you guys are willing to follow me this whole journey. But in the meantime, hope you guys take care. God bless. See you in the next one.